and all agencies of the state in pursuit of truth to find out where we've gone wrong. Today we see in our neighboring country on the western border, for somewhat similar facts, you've almost had earth-shaking consequences because the government of the day did not take certain steps to take certain steps which would bring probity into public life. In India, we've spent 25 years trying to unearth truth, and it's a serious reflection on the health of our entire investigative process, its lack of independence, that despite having got conclusive proof, we are unable to nail where the culprits are. So I'll just give, and I'm more concerned really with the health of our investigative agencies than any other political factor. Obviously, we are all concerned with defense preparedness. It's of utmost importance to us that there is transparency in the procurement process. The government at some stage had taken a decision, perhaps rightly, that we must eliminate middlemen so that collateral considerations don't come in. The government who took the decision needs to be complimented for that. And yet we had, in the mid-90s during a particular purchase, somebody intervening again as middlemen. Even when the disclosures were made in 1987, from 87 till 89, not even a first information report is registered. In 90, some steps are taken. And then you have repeated efforts to make sure that this whole process is stalled. I was personally aghast when I came across a question even being raised before our judicial institutions. The CBI is not a lawfully constituted body which can investigate a case. Something as absurd as this, and therefore efforts were made to stall this. Fortunately, we had interventions of the highest judiciary. The matter proceeded. Thereafter, you have, by that process commencing in 1990, India receiving some documents, and in 1999, a comprehensive charge sheet is filed. I can tell you, sir, just two matters of concern. When the purchases were taking place, one company which had entered the whole process in October 1985 was a company called AE Services. Its contract with the Swedish suppliers was, we shall obtain for you the Indian order on or before 31st of March 1986. Only then we are entitled to kickbacks. So obviously this gentleman was very powerful, he could swing the contract. The contract is finally executed on 24th of March, 1986. Who was this gentleman, and the pursuit of the truth went on? In 1994, the Swiss authorities finally informed the government of India who the recipients were. And they found out that behind this company, the recipient was a gentleman whose name begins with Q. Within 3 days, he is allowed to escape the country. This is how the due process is defeated. Why was he so powerful that he could swing the contract? The monies are traced, the account is traced, you don't need any further conclusive evidence. What did you do when the other governments were in power? In 99, a conclusive charge sheet with entire evidence is put in. When the United Front government was in power, the director CBI brought voluminous documents. The government in 99 takes efforts in Malaysia. The efforts didn't succeed in order to deport him. The government then, after a Friday verdict, moves the Supreme Court in Malaysia on Monday, only to be told he's gone from Malaysia to Argentina. Finally, when the present government came to power in 2004, he's found out in Argentina. The ambassador, Mr. Nath, is told, we don't want to pursue action against him because the action will be costly. There were a series of judicial verdicts which scuttled the whole probe. Each one is appealed against and overturned. In 2004, one probe which says no case is made out is not even appealed against. And we give a whole burial to the case. This is now a sad chapter in history. Nothing more can be done. I don't know if fraud unravels everything. This will be a textbook illustration of a fraud. How to kill the pursuit to get the truth. And every time some disclosure or some interview or some comment comes, it only comes in relation to the fact which are already in, most of them are in public domain. And the facts are very simple. Somebody swung the contract, somebody got the kickbacks, the details of the Swiss accounts, which are very impossible to get, were obtained. Repeated efforts to cover up were there. And this man indeed was very powerful, and then he's allowed to escape. He jumps from one jurisdiction to another. And the Indian state looks helpless. You know the truth. You've got at it, and you are not able to capture the real truth. So my, as I said in the opening, my intention is not to embarrass any government or any party or any individual. But having done it, is it not a case that we introspect? That how easy it has become for people who indulge in these kind of activities to get away. You need friendly governments, you need investigative agencies which have become utterly non-professional. The pace of investigation varies with the political color of the government in power. It slows down with the color of in power. And we prided ourselves when we looked at our Western neighbor, that look what a great democracy we are, the largest in the world, and where are you? And today is a date, and there can't be a better day than this to introspect what they are doing in pursuit of a similar truth, and how helpless we are looking at this. My intention, sir, was only to draw the attention of the House to this hard reality.